I'm always looking for the newest and the latest thing that could possibly prevent cancer. We know that targeted exercise can lower your risk of a cancer recurrence by up to 59%. So I wanted to dig more into exercise and the different strategies that we could use. I wanted to look at this in a really systematic way to see if I could uncover different strategies that might be even more effective. But trying different exercise routines and exercise strategies, well, that has led me down some really crazy paths. Anything from swimming to rebounding to vibrational boards. You name it, I've tried it. But now I want to share with you something that I recently stumbled upon that's making a massive difference in terms of my own cancer recovery and remission. It's called rucking. Rucking is a type of physical activity that involves walking or hiking while carrying a weighted backpack. The term ruck comes from the military, where soldiers would pack up all their gear and carry it in a rucksack. But what it really is taking a really basic exercise movement, walking, and combining it with a form of strength training. Now, targeted exercise has been proven over and over and over again to lower your risk of cancer. This is what's gonna help you stay cancer-free. But what exactly is targeted exercise? Now, targeted exercise for cancer survivors is a combination of strength training and cardio exercise. Both aspects together have been shown to lower your risk of cancer by up to 59%. And this science is very convincing. Ever since I completed my doctorate in cancer care, this science has really exploded. There have been hundreds and hundreds of studies that have all looked at this exact topic. We know that people who strategically use exercise after being diagnosed with cancer, well, they're more likely to get to cancer-free and stay cancer-free. And there are many large cancer prevention guidelines that will tell you the same thing. The American College of Sport Medicine will tell you to incorporate exercise into your cancer prevention strategy. But it's not only reducing your risk of a cancer recurrence. There's more. Using targeted exercise, well, this can also help you be free of the long cancer or chemo side effects that you may still be challenged with. Things like exhaustion or anxiety or lymphedema. Using targeted exercise can help you get rid of all of these symptoms. Now, to get you to this lower risk of cancer, we need to build in two aspects of targeted exercise. The first piece is cardio. That comes from walking. The second piece is strength training, and that comes from rucking. I started rucking by using a weighted vest. I'll link up the exact weighted vest that I use below. I really like this vest, and I have had absolutely no issues with it at all. It always fits comfortably. I go on long walks, I use it frequently, and I've had no issues at all. I also like how adjustable it is. You could potentially run in this weighted vest if you wanted to. It comes in women's and men's sizing, and I'll link it up below. Now, of course, you can use wrist or ankle weights. Those are options as well, but with repetitive movement, something like walking or hiking, that these wrists or ankle weights, well, they can lend you to chafing. And rubbing together or causing chafing, that's obviously not ideal. But a weighted vest doesn't do any of this. No chafing, no pain. Hey, Dr. Amy here, interrupting this video to let you know about the 30-day anti-cancer plan. Now, the contents of this video, it's amazing, but you're gonna need a little bit more support if you truly wanna do everything in your power to stay cancer-free, and that's where I wanna help. The 30-day anti-cancer plan maps out exactly what you should eat, how you should exercise, and your mindset strategy for the next 30 days. I'm gonna put the link below in the description, so go click now and get your copy. Okay, so here's exactly what I did to get started. The weighted vest I have is very adjustable. You're able to remove all of the weights if that's how you feel the most comfortable starting. I started with a couple weights to see how the first walk went, but it was pretty straightforward. It was definitely manageable, so I added in more weights. I've now worked my way all the way up, so I have all the weights in my rucking vest. I typically do about 40 minutes every morning with the vest. Here's what I found. In the summer, I naturally gravitate away from strength training. I'm away from the gym more, my schedule gets more disrupted. I'm just not able to get as many sessions in. But the rucking has really helped me with this. I take a walk every morning, and I typically do not miss my walks in the summer. The weather is great. I love being outside. So it's natural to pair these outdoor walks with a weighted vest. But then I was surprised at how well it worked during the winter. I kept wearing my weighted vest during the winter months to go on outdoor walks, and I would just simply wear a more oversized winter jacket over top of the vest. No one even knew I was wearing a weighted vest underneath my jacket while I was out for my walks. Okay, but what about the results? What did I find? And why do I think that this is so good for stopping cancer? Strength training is critical for cancer survivors. We know that it is going to lower your risk of cancer or a cancer recurrence, but hardly any cancer survivors are actually doing it. But rocking, well, that's a combination of cardio and strength training. You're being extremely effective with your time. I also like rocking for cancer thrivers who are already walking 10,000 steps a day. If you're consistently at 10,000 steps a day, then adding a weighted vest is a very efficient way to get a better workout. I mean, it's really hard to walk any more than 10,000 steps a day. It just becomes rather time consuming. You're literally just running out of time, right? So if you add a weighted vest, then it makes the steps you're already taking even more challenging. This is really turning your walk into progressive strength training, which is exactly what you need to lower your cancer risk. The exercise needs to be progressive, meaning it gets harder, more difficult, more intense over time. And by adding a weighted vest and changing the amount of weight, well, that's progressive. A breast cancer survivor that I work with in the Cancer Freedom Program, well, she found she was really stagnant with her weight loss. Now, of course, being on tamoxifen, it made it challenging for her to drop weight. And a lot of cancer thrivers find this, so she certainly wasn't alone. But the good news is that we designed her nutrition specifically for her and her body now that she was on hormone suppressing medications. Then we paired that with exercise that was going to be more advanced for her. She was already consistently walking 10,000 steps a day, so we just started adding weights to a weighted vest, and she wore that on her walks. It was progressive. It became more challenging over time. Now, you might be thinking, this is pretty intense. It looks like you're wearing a bulletproof vest. The neighbors must think you're a weirdo. And yeah, they might, but I don't really care. If a strategy helps me get to cancer-free and stay cancer-free, then it doesn't matter. I wanna be here for as long as possible, and I wanna be as healthy as possible. So if wearing a weighted vest helps me get there, then that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so I've linked up the weighted vest below, but if you really wanna do everything you can to help stay cancer-free, then we also need to combine targeted exercise with your nutrition. You need a cancer remission nutrition strategy. That's why I'm linking up this next video for you here. Click the link here and I'll see you in the next video.
Okay, you can see here, this is what it looks like when I'm actually wearing the vest. It's really, really comfortable. You can adjust it a lot. You can see here's the compartment again where you can take out the weights and add them back in. I have all of the weights, oh, except for one added into my vest. This is just an empty compartment here. And on the back, there's weights as well. So those can be added in and taken out. And it's really quite breathable. I don't get sweaty or anything like that above and beyond what I normally get when I'm out for a walk.